Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics, guys. Today a short video, guys, on fuel pump replacement on Hyundai Elantra. If you have, guys, Hyundai Elantra from 2011 until 2016, and they made so many of those, they sold so many in the United States and everywhere in the world, we'll show you how to remove and replace fuel pump. That's a weak spot on that Elantra, guys. You can Google on the internet and you see that there is so many fuel pump replacements for being pretty new vehicle, and this one has only 67,000 miles. So this is the new pump that we have right here, the whole assembly with the filter and everything. So stay with us to see how we are going to do that now. First thing that you need to do, you will need to disconnect the battery. Do that, guys, at least 30 minutes before you do the fuel pump replacement. That way you don't have any charge in the system. Okay, you don't want to have any sparks. Do that away from your house. Have a fire extinguisher available, because at any time something might go wrong. Most likely it won't, but it happens. We've seen things go wrong before. So we'll need to get, guys, some gloves, eye protection, face mask. You want eye protection because it might spray fuel in your eyes, because the fuel system is under pressure and we'll need to remove the hose. So if you don't feel confident, don't do that, and always be prepared. Screwdriver, big hammer, most of the times it's like that, and a bucket and shop towel. So the fuel pump, guys, is located under the rear seat, under the rear bottom seat. Most of the cars are that way, imported cars, so stay with us, guys, and we'll show you where exactly it is and how to get to it. So in order to remove the seat, guys, now, okay, first thing that we'll need to do, okay, right here, okay, you get your hand, and right here, let me show you exactly where it is. You need to find them. Okay, there is right here in the middle. Okay, check out where it is. In the middle of the seat, there is a bolt with a 12 millimeter socket. You need extension as well. Okay. We're almost there. And it's pointing that way, up a little bit. Okay, so we need to get it loose. Okay, that's good. And now you can grab the extension and the socket. Okay, hold the bolt with your hand. And you can pull it out. This is the bolt, guys. Okay, there is one more identical to this one on this side, right in the middle of the seat. Okay, and it will take you some time, but you'll be able to see it. Perfect. Okay, you can grab the bolt and later you can start them by hand and just get them tight. When you install the seat, don't forget these bolts. Now, on the front right here, okay, there is two clips, one on this side, one on the other. So you need to grab the seat, push towards the back, okay, and pull up. Okay, and you need to get it with two hands. I cannot do it with one. Okay, like that. It's really, really strong. Now you need to get the seat belts out of the way. Okay, and you can pull the rear seat out of there now. It's loose. Okay, guys, so the fuel pump now is located right here under the seat. It's under this cover, okay, right here. So this cover now on the newer vehicles, they just use silicone to glue it together. Some of the older ones will have like 4, 5, 6, 10 millimeter bolts, which is a better design if you ask me than just that silicone glue right here. But you gotta make sure, okay, that you install some fresh silicone when you do that sealant. Okay, and you can see, okay, where the fuel pump is located now. Okay, right there. Okay, we have the wires now, so we need to disconnect the wires. Okay, and on this one you pull up on the thing. Okay, you pull up and you release it. Now this wire you push in. Yeah, push in. Okay, let me show you. Push this thing and pull it out. Okay, now stay with us to see what else we need to do. Okay, next right here, this is, guys, the fuel line right here, the black and blue thing. Okay, let me show you quick. And you need to put some towels here, because it will leak some fuel. That system is under pressure usually. Unless your pump doesn't work at all, then you won't have pressure. You need to make sure you have eye protection. It might spray fuel in your eyes. So what you need to do now, you need to click on the blue thing down, okay, and pull it out. But let me show you what else it might happen. So you need to support with your finger on the bottom, push towards the front, push on the bluting, and then pull towards the back. Okay, make sure that, okay, some fuel will come out, I guarantee you that. Okay, we didn't have so much because our fuel pump is shot. So, and on this one, we press on both sides in and pull it out, and be careful not to break it. Okay, just make sure that everything slides out easy. Again, be careful not to spray fuel or anything, guys, because you're working with fuel. So you have to be very, very patient. You have to have fire extinguisher again with you. Okay, and this is the cap here that holds the fuel pump in place. Okay, and that metal ring that holds the fuel pump, this one is recommended to replace it with every fuel pump replacement. And we need to go counterclockwise to get it loose. Okay, this one came loose pretty easy. Some will be really stuck, I guarantee you that. Okay, and this one will not be able to come out. It will come out with the fuel pump. We'll have to lift it up a little bit. And then just lift up the pump a little bit. We'll be able to eventually get the ring out of there. Okay, like that. So that's the fuel pump. So it's very, very tight fit, guys. And some of you probably got to that point and wonder what to do next. So, this thing is part of the emission system, evaporative system. So you need to spread those things and pull it out. Careful not to break anything, okay, because that's fragile. You just need to have both of them and pull it out. Okay, like that. That way we will have a little bit more room to play with. Okay, next we have the fuel lines. You have to pull the pump up a little bit and just remove the fuel lines out of the way. Okay, like that. And then the fuel pump will get stuck. And that's normal. You have to help it a little bit with the screwdriver, guys. Because it's the tightest fit I've seen on any vehicle, this one right here. Okay, and then we have the floaty thing that measures the fuel tank. And you need to have a bucket ready. Okay. And you have to immediately put the pump in the bucket because you'll spill some gas. Okay, if you spill any in the car, clean it immediately and shampoo the carpet. We have the procedure how to do that on our channel. You can see it's almost full tank of gas right now. And this is, guys, the fuel pump assembly. We'll recommend replacing, okay, the whole fuel pump assembly. You can replace the fuel pump itself, but it's recommended to do the whole assembly. So we got a new pump, guys. We'll have the links in the description of the video where we got the parts from. Very affordable price, and comes with a new ring, so that's great. You're supposed to replace that every time you replace a fuel pump. Okay, so it comes with the floaty thing that measures the fuel level as well. Comes equipped with everything, the whole kit. Okay, so we'll just go ahead and remove the safety caps on the top. Okay, and we have a notice. Let's read this one quick. Original black pressure sensor must be reused at time of installation. And this is the pressure sensor, okay, right here, guys. So you need to spread the two things, okay, and pull it out. Okay, so you need to help it a little bit if it's stuck with a screwdriver, but just careful not to break anything. Okay, it has an O-ring actually, so it needs to come out. Just very, very gently remove it out of there. Okay, right there, guys. That's the seal now. You can see you have to inspect that seal, make sure that it's good. And you need to press it in, make sure it's all the way on the sensor. And just push it in. Okay, perfect, like that. Okay, guys, so make sure that your new pump comes with those rubber seals, rubber bushings on the bottom. Otherwise, it will be very noisy if you don't install those. So make sure you did that, forgot to mention, before we continue. Okay, guys, and we're ready to put it in now. You have to be careful with the floaty thing that measures your fuel level. Okay, it goes first. Okay, now you will go only one way. And It's easier, guys. Okay, you can push it in a little bit, but you can actually remove that valve right there, whatever that thing is. It's part of the emission systems. Okay, so we'll just pull it on the side so we can get the pump in, and then we'll install it. Okay, like that. Now we can go ahead actually and install that part, because otherwise, if you put too much pressure, you don't want to break it. Okay, clicked in place, perfect. Careful that the fuel line is not in the way. Okay, it's gonna go in now. It goes only one certain way now, and that's where the fuel pump will be. Before you push it in all the way in, make sure that you install the locking ring in place. Okay, now get the lines out of the way again, and you need to get the pump in place now. Okay, it's almost there, you just need to find the spot where it goes in. Okay, the ring is in place, you need to turn it clockwise now. Okay, and we'll need to close it now. Just be very careful when you use a screwdriver, because if you go the wrong way, okay, you're going to punch a hole in the fuel tank, and you don't want that to happen. Okay, we got it tight all the way. You can see where the teeth are supposed to be on ours. Okay, so now we can go ahead and connect the hoses. Okay, you just push them in. Perfect, you hear that click. Now we have the emission hose right there. The evaporative system. This one is in. We need to install the wires. And if you messed up your silicone, you need to install new silicone. So stay with us to see if it's going to start now. Okay guys, next, go wash your hands, remove your gloves, make sure you don't have the old fuel pump close to you, dispose it the right way, make sure you don't have gas, and we'll connect the battery, because if you have spark and fuel, you're gonna catch on fire, so be careful how you do that now. So we have the new fuel pump in place, and now the fuel system is empty, so you will need to do something so the car can start faster that way. Otherwise you'll be turning for probably a minute until the fuel system is full of fuel and you can start it. Okay guys, with the battery connected, so turn the key on and off about 10 times. Okay, check it out, like that. And we're going to go ahead and see if it's going to start fast now. Okay, perfect. You can see, done deal. Make sure you guys install the seat the correct way, get the bolts tight, don't forget the bolt. And that's how you guys remove and replace fuel pump on Hyundai Elantra. Thank you guys for watching, please subscribe and let's grow that channel together.